Ready. I seem to have gotten myself in quite a fix here, haven't I? Well, one way or another, this game will be over soon. I gotta say, this is not looking so good for the home team here. Might as well add some pressure to this pawn. There's really no reason for it to be there. Course, the ultimate trick here is to land rook f1 without Zug noticing. Which is gonna be a bit of magic if it does happen. But if it doesn't happen, well, I'm kinda hosed, so we have to play hope chess at this point. Play the cards I have. Unless there's a better square for my bishop. Alright, let's get my king closer to this, I guess. Well, I'm not calculating this correctly, I guess. Is there any trick I have here? Like, I can't fortress this, so I have to force something tactically. I recognize that this is completely tactically flawed, but I don't know what else I can try here. At least I've got him thinking. Or he's practicing music. Alright, so here's where magic maybe happens. Getting a fortress here looks impossible, but if enough pawns go off the board, then, maybe things happen. Well, as long as this and that don't get forked, I'm okay. Yeah, so you have to go back. So I have a big decision to make here. Do I do Bishop E2 or not? I think I have to. And the hope of the dream is to land it on G4 with H5 played. And then all I have to worry about is how do I stop the A pawn, which is still an enormous problem, but it's just one problem.
Cool shot.
Yeah, I didn't think he was going to let that slide. So do I go to D1? Do I double down here? Or do I wimp back and go to A6? Well, A6 looks atrocious, so D1 it is, I guess. Still, all of my pieces are pretty well protected, so this isn't so easy for Zug to break through. I could take the extra C pawn if I wanted to. I'm not sure it's in my interest to take it. We'll take it. Unless there's some ridiculous fork. No, there can't be a fork. The bishop would cover any possible fork. I wonder. I just might learn something about rook endgames today. Or rook and queen endgames. I just might learn which ones are drawn and which ones are not. And the reason I say this is my bishop actually covers that square. It looks like it doesn't, but there's a good chance that this bishop is not going to be long for this world. Now, do I have time for rook g6? Does rook g6 turn reality on its head? No, because he just plays king c3. So I have to take this. And now I have to decide which side does my king belong on. I think this side because I don't get mated over here. Oh, wait. He might have a plan here. We'll see. Wait, what's this king move? What's this intending? Oh. I'm afraid of King F7 and the queen pinning my rook. You know I'm going to miscalculate something here. You just know it's going to happen. But you play the game anyway. Can only wonder what Zug is thinking. It's not so clear what black should do. Forced to do that. Yeah, I can concede this. Very good game. Analysis might show otherwise, but you know, who's keeping score? I guess Stockfish will. For those of you curious and watching the game, yeah, I've run the computer analysis on it. One thing that was instructive about this was the exchange of the queen for the rook. So, it went a little differently than I expected. I was kind of thinking something, I don't know exactly what, but something like this. I don't know how you'd get here, but I was thinking this might happen. And again, black is just out of moves. Now, if this pawn were somewhere else, or I'm sorry, if these pawns weren't here, if this and this were off the board, then black could just shuffle the rook back and forth, and it's a little bit more difficult for white. I'm not sure if it's winning or not. It's certainly being able to shuffle the rook between two squares is a big deal. Likely earlier I messed up here. Like, I hesitated before taking this pawn, because I thought that one formation I need is this, with this kind of thing. I just didn't look enough at it, and I don't know if that works or not. So feel free to analyze that offline, let me know what you think. And yeah, well played, Zug. So thanks to everybody for watching, and thanks to No Joke for running this ladder, and to Zug for playing. It's been a fun game. Wow, look at that graph. Alright, guys. So that's it. I guess I'll throw us all over to Zug Addict and say thanks for watching.